Hey guys, Jeff Dickinson here, and man, this is badass. Check it out. So, if you've been watching my videos, you know I collect diecast cars, especially the 124, 118 scale. And I've been on the hunt for Smokey and the Bandit Trans Ams, and I came across this at a collectible store. Now, I've never gotten a Greenlight car before, and this is an Artisan version. And what I found intriguing about this, it's a limited edition 118 scale. So I was asking the guy at the store, has he heard about this? He's like, no, some guy traded it in for other stuff, and we made a deal. Now, how much you're paying, you're wondering. Well, I've been eyeing things on eBay lately, and I've seen this before, going anywhere between $75 all the way up to $150. So I told him that I'll give him $60 for this car, and he's like going, well, you know, we have it priced at $89, which is a fair deal. But I was like, well, no, I'll just give you $60. If you don't want it, no big deal, I'll walk away. And it was the only one there in the store. Well, as I was looking at other collectibles and getting ready to check out, he's like, you know what? I'll go ahead and throw it in for that price. So I lucked out. So this is my very first time I get to see a Greenlight limited edition Artisan. So we're going to check this out together. Now, this is a really good looking box. This is what the side looks like. Now, I wish they had two, because I probably would have picked up both of them. You know, always want one to keep and one to collect. Now, as you read this, and remember, this movie came out when Star Wars came out. And I remember seeing Star Wars with my family, and my dad took us to see Smokey and the Bandit, which is why I got hooked on this movie and car. That movie was killer. And here's the other side of it. Let me show you the bottom here. So it came out 2017 here. And why I have not seen this before, I don't know. But I'll be looking closer at these cars, especially these Artisan. Because the way I understand it, these collectibles are very unique. Now, if you can see here at the box, let me turn this around again. It's got a little dent here, like indention. But it's no big deal because I'm going to open it up anyway. But I like to keep the boxes as a collector. I don't know how you guys are, but I'm a guy who wants to collect this and keep the box. So let's go ahead and get my trusty knife out. And there's a... here and we got one here and got one here to open this up. All right, oh wow, there's a styrofoam. Well, I know the box was like, is there anything in here? No. I know the box was cut, here, let me show you the box. It's kind of thin, hence why I guess that's why it got a little damaged there. But wow, this is cool. So it comes in a nice styrofoam case. I'm impressed. Collecting these diecast cars, I've never seen one like this before. So that says bottom. Okay, so this is top. All right. So what I want to do here, bring out the knife again. Guess cut here. Not sure if I'm cutting the styrofoam or tape. I hope I'm cutting the tape. Gotta go all the way around, I guess. Let's see here. It leads off here. I'm trying to cut the tape, not the styrofoam. I like to keep the styrofoam and keep collectible intact. Alright, let's see here. Maybe this is easier. I'll just follow the groove. I don't want to mess up the styrofoam. Part of the charm. Okay, I see where it is. I was cutting a little bit of styrofoam. Okay. And oh, I see here. Yeah, unfortunately, I got a little bit of the styrofoam. But now I'm seeing where... It's kind of hard to see where the tape is and where the styrofoam is. So if you guys get one of these and open one up... Because of the way the layering is and stuff, it's kind of hard to tell. Let's see here. I'm just glad it's secured like this. This is the best packaging I've seen for any die-cast car. Alright, I think... Once again, I'm like wondering if I'm cutting into the styrofoam. Okay, there we go. Okay. Well, has this nice little bag here to protect it. Let me show you here. I think we're done with the knife. Wow. Cool. Yeah, so it comes with like this little baggie here. And yeah, I was cutting into the styrofoam, as you can see. Alright. Damn. Well, I always like to keep the styrofoam here. With the, well, not always like to keep the styrofoam. I always like to keep the packaging together. So what we'll do here is... Box over here. Take a look at the car. This is pretty heavy, man. So that's plastic little thing here. Wheels are rubber. That's pretty cool. Let me see if I can zoom in here a little bit. It's got the, sorry guys. Let me zoom out. Let it adjust. So you can see there, it's got the, let me do this here. The Trans Am logo. Pretty badass. Alright. It's got T-tops. Did these come up? Well, it didn't come with any instructions. It's got the nice little Pontiac symbol there. That is not a sticker. But it's got the little symbol there. Pretty good detail. There's another plastic little thing there for lights. I just am blown away on how detailed that little Trans Am logo on the tires is. The paint scheme looks really cool. If you see any little dust specks from the Starfire, I apologize. Fresh out of the bag. Styrofoam everywhere. That's plastic still, yep. And it's got nice little pipes here coming out. Oh, cool. It's got the Band One. It's all plastic here. That's a sticker? Kinda? No. That's plastic. Okay, that's plastic. Band One's plastic. Sorry about the zooming in and out. So the Trans Am thing feels flush with it, like the paint job. Wow. And the Band One, it's plastic. So they did that. Got 76 on there. Now, if I remember right, sorry about the styrofoam again. If I remember right, you know, because this came out in 77, they filmed Smokey and the Bandit in 76. So this is directly a 76 Trans Am, maybe? But they're labeling a 77? Not 100%. Let's take a look at the top here. Well, the hood doesn't open. Sorry, trying to get all the styrofoam off. It's got Trans Am there and the bird. Let's see if I can do this here. Let me lower it a bit. Zoom in a little bit. TA66. Alright, so the scoops got the little number on there. That's cool. And we got the Trans Am logo. Let me zoom out a little bit more. That's kind of cool. Trunk doesn't open, but oh look, the door's open. So let's take a look here. Oh wow, let's see here. Try to get my finger in there. Yeah, it's a sticker. I figured things like this would be a sticker, but it's okay. Let you see some detail in there. Let me zoom out a little bit here. Whoa. That's fabric. They have carpeting in there. Check that out. Okay, hold on. Let me see if you can see all that. Let me zoom out a little bit. Yeah. It's got some velvet feel to it, like a carpet. Oh, talk about detail. Alright. Dashboard looks correct. Steering wheel doesn't move because the tires don't move. Back it out a little bit. Detail right there to the door, including if you can see that. I don't know if you can see that right here. But it's got the Trans Am logo on the door. Let me open up the other side here. take a look here. There's that little logo right there. That's some really cool detail. There are stickers for the mirror. So, yeah. No surprise there. Let's take a look in here. Look at that. I am really blown away. Let me back out a little bit. I'm blown away right here. It's got carpeting. Let me show you the inside a little bit better. How cool is that? It's got carpeting. Seats? Oh my goodness, the seats are, they're not rubber, but they're like cushiony a little bit. Hard to, well, not, well, it's not rubber, it's just maybe a soft plastic. Hopefully you can see some of that detail inside. I wonder, I was hoping these T-tops could, let me back out a little bit. I wonder if these T-tops can come off a little bit. But they seem to be in there permanently. It would be too bad because I could remove the T-tops if that was possible. Nice little detail on the T-tops. Wow. Let's take a, let me raise it up a little bit higher. I want to take a look underneath here. So the tires are like a hard rubber. It's not a soft rubber, it's a hard rubber. There's some detail right there. Greenlight 1977 Pontiac Fiber Trans Am. Universal Studios. Wow, that's kind of cool. And guys, this thing weighs like a nice amount of weight here. Let me lower this a little bit. Let's go back inside and see if I could do this justice for you. I'm just blown away on the detail. Especially the carpeting. This is right here. Nice and soft velvet. I don't know if you're catching that. That's some killer detail. The seats. I mean, they're, see, it's kind of not hard plastic, but not rubber, but it's kind of between. And it's flexible a little bit. For those who appreciate these kind of cars and collectibles, the detail, the more detail, the cooler. Now it looks like there's some, I don't know how they do this, but however they did the carpeting, that was really cool. It's also like, see right here how it comes up a little bit. I have my door, the door open, and the camera going here. Hopefully it won't get in the way. See what I'm talking about? Like right there. Maybe it's something they spray on, a flock on, maybe? Some detail on the interior of the door. Nothing too much there. But yeah, not bad. I'm really stoked about this Band 1 license plate. If you saw that video of the Jada 124 scale I got, it just said Smokey and the Bandit back there. I gotta watch the movie again to see all the details, but this looks spot on from what I can remember. It's been about a minute since I seen Smokey and the Bandit. Yeah, that's some pretty cool detail. Down to the little... Hear that? Carpet. Whoever they did to put it on there. Now I'm trying to figure out, it's not like glued, I guess, maybe flocked. I've seen people do this with train sets where they flock things. So maybe that has something to do with it. I don't know. Sorry, didn't mean to hit the camera, the door. I'm trying to show you details without the camera being in the way. But yeah, man. Pretty super cool. And the details on the doors, it's really cool. This is all smooth, like painted on, so that's kind of cool. Sorry if my finger kind of made it blurry a little bit. I'm really stoked about the tires. How detailed they got it. Especially with the logo. Oh. I think I lost focus there. There we go. Sorry. Just wanted you to see some of this detail. Look at that. There you go. That is badass. Now see if I could do this some justice. Car moves pretty good. Hopefully you catch some of this. There you go. Well, guys, this has been a treat and a half for me. Smokey and the Bandit. The Artisan version. By Greenlight. So if you want to score one of these guys, I suggest, you know, eBay's one way. Like I said, I just didn't appreciate the price fluctuation and I lucked out when I went to my collectible store. But yeah, I guess, you know, outsource the best way you can, and eBay's one of them. These are no longer available for sale. So you're at the mercy of whoever's selling them. Well, guys, hope you appreciate the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hit the like button if you thought it was cool, and especially if you enjoy Smokey and the Bandit. And what we'll do here is catch you on the next one. Laters, guys. I'm going to check out Smokey and the Bandit. Laters.